Serbia hosted the 60th anniversary of the Non-Aligned Movement Summit 2 weeks ago. Joining me on the line from Kigali, Rwanda, with the outcome of the two-day summit is the acting head of multilateral relations and cooperation at the Ministry of International Relations and Cooperation, Ambassador Jerobeam Shaanika. Ambassador, good morning and thank you so much for joining us here on Good Morning Namibia.
Hello, good morning. Good morning. How are you?
Fantastic. How are you doing this morning?
I'm doing well, and I'm glad to hear you are doing well.
Ambassador, just to start with, perhaps you can briefly tell us what the Non-Aligned Movement is all about.
Well, the Non-Aligned Movement, known by its abbreviation as NAM, is a movement of 20 countries which was formed on the 1st of September in 1961 in Belgrade, in the former Yugoslavia then, by leaders such as Joseph Broz Tito, of the then Yugoslavia, and the then Indian Prime Minister, Jawaharlal Nehru, the then Egyptian President, Gamal Abdel Nasser, the then Ghanaian President, Dr. Kwame Nkrumah, and Sukarno of Indonesia. So it was established as a forum for consultation, collaboration on advocacy for peace, cooperation, and for strengthening multilateralism. So the Non-Aligned sought to create an independence path in the world politics that will not result in member states becoming hostage to major geopolitical power contestation. As you remember, the famous assertion by Julius Nyerere that warning that when elephants are fighting, it is the grass will suffer. So that was an escape route to avoid the entanglement. It was also based on the principles of the Badug Conference, which was known as Asia-Africa Conference, which was held in Badug City in the West Java province of Indonesia in 1955 to, among other, promote solidarity in developmental policy and decision, political decisions such as self-determination, decolonization among countries in the global south. In short, it represents the interests and aspirations of developing countries. You know, as Professor Hans Morgenthau said, the world, imperfect as it is from the rational point of view, it is a result of forces which are inherent of human nature. And of course, to improve that, Morgenthau thought, one must work with the forces, as those forces, not against them. So I believe the Non-Aligned is still relevant in the world today. It was created to drive international cooperation, and today it's champion, or it still champion, the respect for the principles enshrined in the Charter, advocating for the revitalization of the United Nations General Assembly, reform of the Security Council so that it reflects the equitable geographical representation in order to respond to the present global reality with legitimacy and effectiveness.
Thank you. Talk to us about the highlights of you know, what the highlights were of the two-day high-level commemorative meeting that marked the 60th anniversary of this non-alignment movement.
Well, the highlight, the principal among them was to mark the 60th anniversary of the Non-Aligned Movement. That is, of course, the reaffirmation of the relevance of the Non-Aligned Movement in world politics today. Although the challenge of 1961 are no longer the same, there are new challenges that have emerged, such as the COVID-19 pandemic, that the member state advocated for global creation of a UN high-level panel on global recovery from COVID-19, and of course the participation in the COP26 in Glasgow was also discussed. As you know, that many member states are really facing the impact of the climate change. I mean, if you were to talk to the countries in the Caribbean or in the Pacific, even everywhere, these are countries that are living or faced by the challenge of the climate change. So it was a way to reflect on what NAM has achieved and also just to kind of view the pothole in the path of history so that you can avoid them in future. And of course, they also call for the reform of the UN, particularly the Security Council, to reflect the equitable geographical representation in order to respond to the present global reality with, as I say, with legitimacy and effectiveness. Mm-hmm. And of course, to decry the double standard and selectivity in international relations, particularly when certain countries approach issues of such as self-determination and other with a double standard. But last but not the least, of course, it's also provided opportunity for member states to engage in bilateral meeting on the margin of the high-level commemorative meeting.
And what was the outcome of the commemorative meeting of the non-aligned movement?
Well, the outcome is just to remain true to the objective, as I've pointed out, that we are faced by challenge as non-aligned. And of course, the non-aligned movement is one of the largest gathering of member states outside the UN or beside the UN. That's kind of reaffirmation of respect to human rights and the principles of the Charter. And of course, to as you know, that most of the members of the non-aligned movement have faced targeted sanction, and of course, to stand together. And of course, also to kind of be a block of unity when in terms of issues that are emerging. So that, those were the outcome of the high-level commemorative.
Mm-hmm. Talk to us about what advantage Namibia has, you know, in the non-aligned movement.
Well, the advantage, let me just kind of tell you, in diplomacy, there are key words such as leverage, influence, and persuade. So to enable to influence decision at the international level, Namibia need to align itself with countries pursuing the same goal to make an impact. You know, to and I give you the example of the snowflakes that are fragile when standing alone, but together they form a strong. And of course, Namibia's multilateral priorities speak to the promotion of social progress and better standard of living in larger freedom, as envisioned in the Charter. We have priorities such as youth empowerment, gender equality, quality education, technology and innovation, and infrastructure development, just to mention a few. And Namibia will benefit from its member states when we bargain as a bloc that stand together to advocate for the priority that we as countries from the developing South we want to see champion at the international level. And I think you see the issue of COVID-19. We have all spoke about the apartheid COVID, the way the other countries, those who are developed, were trying to only have this thing to themselves. And the issue of patent was also discussed, so that if we want to eliminate COVID-19, we must make sure that every country has attained the same level to enable to eliminate it altogether. But you cannot have it in some countries while other countries are left out. So inclusion is one of the issues that if Namibia is speaking through the membership of non-aligned, I think that it will drive benefit than to stand alone.
Ambassador, just very, very briefly, before I let you go, any final remarks you'd like to leave us with?
Hello, your voice is beginning to fade.
I was saying just before we go, very briefly, your final remarks.
Well, my final remarks, I can only say that the non-aligned is still relevant in the way that there are still challenges facing the developing countries. And of course, if we as developing countries shy away, I can only caution you that there is a caution from Dante Alighieri that the hottest places in hell are reserved for those who, in times of great moral crisis, maintain their neutrality. And I don't think there is a way we can maintain our crisis while we are facing challenge that we cannot tackle them.
Ambassador, thank you for your time and thank you for speaking to us this morning.
Thank you very much. It was an honor for me to speak to you also.
That was the acting head of multilateral relations and cooperation at the Ministry of International Relations and Cooperation, Ambassador Jerobeam Shaanika, speaking to us about the 60th anniversary of the Non-Aligned Movement Summit that was hosted in Serbia 2 weeks ago.